guest star of Romy and Michelle. My fifth grade paper was called Death of an Icon, and I wrote it on Princess Diana because she died 3 days before fifth grade, and you met her! Oh! So when you were growing up in Scotland, did you always know you wanted to be an actor? Did you know that's something you wanted to do?
It wasn't, I didn't always know, but when I was a little boy, a theatre company came to my school to do a play from the local theatre company, and I saw them, and I remember like, it was like a Barbara Stanwyck movie, like I was looking through the wires of the fence. You know what I mean? Like someone.
I don't think we have those movies in America. We're not going to catch them.
You know Barbara fucking Stanwyck?
Yeah, she's good.
Okay, so it'd be like. I'm trying to think of a modern equivalent. So like a prison movie. Where like the heroine is in jail.
Hunger Games, that's a good one.
Yeah, and she's looking at her daughter who's been married and she can't see her daughter be married because she's in jail.
I think that's Fiddler on the Roof.
I saw them like taking the baskets with all the props and everything into a van to go to the next school and do the next show. And that's when I thought, I want to be an actor.
I wanted to be an actor because I saw Annie and wanted to be an orphan. That's so weird. It was very similar.
I was Annie.
You were Annie?
No, I was Annie.
Who did you play?
No, I just fucked Annie.
You fucked Annie. When did you come to New York City? When did you come to America?
I first ever came to New York City in 1996. Oh, yeah. A movie.
Yeah.
A movie was opening and the premiere was here and I came for the first time ever.
Did you fall in love?
And as the plane was like circling, I thought I could see New York from above and I thought I want to live here. I live from the plane, I knew.
From the plane. I fly Southwest, the megabus of the sky. What do you fly? What's your name? What's your name?
Virgin,
yeah. Something we haven't been for. I feel it. Isn't that disgusting? That's just the grossest thing in the world. But I shaved just for you. Like, yeah. It's wet other places too. I'm gonna dive on in. Now, what's your? You've got a lot of great movies, the Flintstones, and Romeo and Michelle is my favorite movie ever.
I like it.
It's good. It's a good movie.
What's wrong with the Flintstones?
It's not absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
Yabba dabba doo, girl. Now, what is your favorite film you've ever been in?
Do you mean But do you mean the favorite film as in like the finished film or the experience of that doing it? Oh.
Oh. Yes. That's what I keep using. Let's answer both. Oh, let's go the experience. Like, what was the best experience, like film?
My favorite experience of ever doing a film was drum roll, please. Spice World. I'll tell you what, because since 1997, Spice Girls, like the height of
their... They were the Beatles of like the Beatles.
And I'd been in Hollywood doing some dopey films, and then I missed the Spice Girl thing. And so I came back to London, and... Oh, this is so hilarious. And they were like, the Spice Girls want you to be in their movie.
Yes.
I was like, what? And so I was like, of course. And I played, like, a few years before that, I played Hamlet. And Jenny from the Spice Girls was so, don't laugh, but it's kind of funny, but like her dad died, not funny.
Oh,
but 3 days after Jerry's dad died, she was at college, and her college trip to the theater was seeing me playing Hamlet, and Hamlet's all about your dad dying, right? So Jerry saw me playing Hamlet, and so when they were doing the Spice Girls film, she was like, I want him to be in the film because he had a special connection to me and my dad. And so I went, forever I wanted to have a t-shirt printed saying, Jelly Spice saw my Hamlet. So then I did Spice World, and it was like at the height of their fame, and I learned all of the Spice Girls dance moves from the Spice Girls.
Let's go! Yeah.
I could do Spice of Your Life.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make some noise for the incredible encounter.